Hey, what's up, everybody? You know what this is. It's your boy Will. And first, let me give you a quick just rundown what I thought about the last debate. Horses and bayonets, you know, that was all the rage on Twitter and on YouTube. And, you know, everybody was making jokes about it. But if you honestly think about it, remember how in the first debate, everybody was talking about how Romney was going to have a bunch of zingers? Because he was desperate. He was coming into the first debate behind, and he needed to do something big in order to push himself forward. Well, guess what we saw in the last debate? With the Romney momentum from the first debate, him holding his own in the second debate, this was, I mean, you would think that Obama was down by 3, 4, 5 points the way he was attacking when he came in to this third debate. He looked more like the challenger, and Romney looked more like the incumbent. So he had no choice but to come in with zingers and horses and bayonets, and the 80s need their policy back. I mean, that's not presidential. Can you imagine if Romney would have said those things, the firestorm the press would have had? It would have been an absolute massacre in the press if Romney would have had those type of quotes from his performance versus the president's performance. So the press is so biased. It's sad how biased the press is. And if Romney wins, I mean, that goes to show you how bad Obama is. Now, talking about desperation, that leads to what I really want to talk about in this video, and that is this Lena Dunham commercial or advertisement or campaign ad for the Obama campaign. Now, I have no idea who this woman is. I've never seen her in anything, but I think she's really important to millennials, people 18 to 25. And she has this commercial where she's talking about the equivalent of losing your virginity to the right person is like voting for the right person. Now, if I was a woman, this whole war on women facade and this whole catering to women's issues, and they're not even really catering to women's issues, because like I used a very controversial title for this video for a reason. The Obama campaign think you are all hoes. Like, all you care about is how you can stop a baby from coming out of your hole. They think that contraception, birth control is all you care about. Not jobs, not the deficit, not taking care of of your loved ones, or, you know, moving up, taking more take-home pay, lower taxes. All they think you care about is some dude busting a nut up in your poo-tang and not getting you pregnant because you have the right contraception. That's what the Obama campaign thinks of America's women. They think you are a hoe. And that's it. And you should be mortified. You should be angry and upset. And you should be standing in line a mile long to vote against this guy who sees you as nothing, as a hoe. I mean, he's not just a hole, a hoe. Barack Obama thinks you are all hoes. Because, see, he thinks that all single women are laying up in somebody's bed like Sex in the City, and all y'all need in order for your life to be complete is some rights to contraception. Not a job, not more take-home pay, etc., etc. So you should be very, very angry and upset that that's what this campaign thinks of you. Say what you want about the 47% of comment from Romney or any other lies that the Obama campaign has been pushing forward instead of an agenda for the next 4 years. And the one that should piss you off as a woman is that they have this young girl come up there and tell you that, you know, when I voted for Barack Obama, I pulled back the curtain and I pulled the lever for Barack Obama. I thought the girl was gonna nut right there on screen on my YouTube screen. It was absolutely insulting. And every woman who sees this should be insulted. I mean, this campaign, the Obama campaign has, I mean, they called the dude a murderer, okay? And now they're calling all women hoes. Because that's what basically the war of women is all about. Sandra Fluky or Fluke or whatever her name is, basically she's a hoe. All she cares about is making sure she don't have no whiny ass baby. Contraception, birth control, Planned Parenthood, contraception, birth control. Oh yeah, mammograms too. I mean, it's so insulting. I don't know how any woman, Romney should be 60 points ahead of Obama when it comes to women. But you women don't understand, they are calling you a hoe because all you care about is your hole. And I know, and you should know, that women are smarter than that. They are more than just their lady parts. It's sad and it's pathetic, and that should be the number one reason. You know, the insulting, just amazingly dismissive attitude the so-called signer of the Lilly Ledbetter Act has towards women. And once again, let's talk about the Lilly Ledbetter Act. The Lilly Ledbetter Act doesn't give women equal pay. It just made it easier for to sue the company that you believe, that you believe is not giving you equal pay. Now look up the statistics on that and see how many times you actually seen somebody win those arguments in court. Obama is an empty suit. He doesn't give a damn about anyone but himself. His whole campaign has been a smear tactic, negative campaign meant to destroy. Hope and change is out the window, gone. Gone. He does not care about hope and change. It was a platitude then. It didn't work. He knows he's a failure. So all he can do is tear down Romney and do these specific pinpoint ads to try to get back his base. That's all he has. He has nothing left. So, America, you have a choice. The women of America, you have a choice. Either you can vote for the guy who's talking about getting you jobs, more take-home pay. Yeah, he may not be the most glamorous and the most cool guy. Yeah, he's been married to his wife and he doesn't drink coffee or pop or anything like that. Or you can go with the cool guy who goes to Las Vegas and then to the David Letterman show as our embassies burn in Benghazi. So you have a choice between these two very distinct paths for our country. The one who's calling you a hoe and the one who wants to get you back to work. I'm your boy, Will. I'm out.